Welcome back to my YouTube channel, or my beauty to YouTube channel. Here's the tutorial that we're gonna be doing today. This beautiful look, I assume it's gonna be called purple rain or something like that, because most of the colors are purple or kind of burgundy shades. I'm gonna be using a gray on the outer part just to give a little more depth, and to balance out so many cold undertones on the lid, I'm gonna be using a very warm undertone gold eyeshadow on the teared area. So if you wanna know how we do this purple rain, I think it is gonna be called, makeup look, just keep on watching. We're gonna start with a base. We're gonna be using a paint pot. This is Soft Ochre by MAC all over the lid. And then I'm gonna start enhancing really softly the crease with a matte shade. This is Pink Mauve from Lorac Matte Shade on the crease. And I'm gonna go for a little more intense. This is Burgundy from the Sun Palette, just on the crease. Now we're gonna give some color. I'm gonna be using the Burgundy Reddish shade by Makeup Forever. This is the shade S848, and I'm gonna be applying it in the same way. And also I'm gonna bring it down to the upper lash line, just in a triangle shape, keeping the colors in that area. Next is gonna be to adding a little bit of intensity to the this area. So I'm gonna be using a matte shade. This is a gray shade, this by Makeup Forever also. This M106, and I'm gonna be applying on the same area in a triangle shape, but I'm gonna make sure that previous shades show off, so this doesn't really cover them, just giving some intensity. If they cover that, you can reapply the previous shade just a little bit. Now for the rest of the lid, I'm gonna be applying another purple shade, but for that I'm gonna first apply another coat of a cream product, the paint pot, just on the lid, making sure I just get the rest of the color that we applied on the outer part completely showing off. The color I'm gonna be using for Makeup Geek is Sensuous, all over the lid, and reapply it if you need to, the previous shade, just to combine all together. And also make sure that everything is completely blended out into the skin and it has a nice smooth area. For the teared area, I'm gonna give a nice warm effect. I'm gonna be using the D410 from Makeup Geek in a diamond shade, this gold shade from the teared area all the way to the one pair of a lid. For the bottom lash line, I'm gonna go once again from there using the gray shade and blend it with the transition shade we used. And I'm gonna add a little bit of beige shade in matte formula on the arch of the eyebrow. Gonna intensify the upper lash line with a J liner. This is Ebony by Krylon, and we're not gonna make any kind of wig. Also, I'm gonna be using the same product on the bottom waterline. Gonna curl my lashes and apply mascara, and afterwards I'm gonna be applying some false lashes. But first I'm gonna be retouching my eyebrows, and I'm gonna be quite nice and defined in here because I wanted to combine and make one look all together. For the face, I'm gonna start with a water-based primer. This is Water Makeup Base by Sensei, playing with my hands because it works really well with this foundation on top. This is the Makeup Skin by Urban Decay in the shade 4.0. And I'm gonna blend it all over my face and neck. And for the irritation area I have underneath my nose, I'm gonna be playing with my finger. And as a concealer, I'm gonna be using the same Naked Skin Shades Concealer in Urban Decay, but the shade is Medium Light Neutral. Gonna be applying it on the dark circle areas and also to cover some other imperfections. And to make sure this doesn't move, I'm gonna be set it really precisely with the loose powder. This is HD Makeup Forever powder. This is the one that I'm gonna be using. And for the rest of the face, because I have quite dry skin, I don't want it to go overboard with too much powder, so I'm gonna dust it really lightly. I'm gonna give a little more volume back to my face using the lighter shade of the Shade & Light Palette Contour Palette by Kat Von D. And just on the hollows of the cheeks, the temple and the jawline, but you should adjust this to your shape. For blush, I'm gonna do Adorable Pink by Kiko on the top of this contour I did. And for highlighted on top of this blush is gonna be a Moonstone by Becca Cosmetics. We are nearly done. Last touch is gonna be reapplying a little bit the eyeliner to cover the base of the lashes. And for the lips, I'm gonna go for Corsica, which is a liquid lipstick by NARS. Finish everything with a setting spray by Motifs 10 Years Younger, and we are done.
Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this makeup tutorial. So the list of products to recreate this look as always is gonna be on the bar below next to a ton of other links of the tutorial that may like to see, reviews and testing products and all that. But of course, you don't need to use exactly the same product. Go more for the shades and finishes and then instead the brand. So maybe you have already so many of these shades, similar shades on your that you own, so you can recreate it without having to buy many more products. So just have that in mind. Here you have a direct link to subscribe to this my beauty channel and my previous tutorial. Give a thumbs up to this video so I know you like it and you enjoy it. And of course, there's my social media that you can find and send me pictures of you recreate this look or saying hi to me and all of that junk. So as always, thanks so much for spending some time with me. Be happy and see you next one. Ciao.